not want it. I find that very amusing. You see, once there was a younger lady.
Well, I must be going on with my letters. It seems a little warmer and drier.
My charming hostess looks upset. What is it, dear lady?
Just a little trouble with the snow, that's all.
Yes, the snow makes things very difficult. What else makes them very easy? Yes, very easy.
I don't know what you mean.
Oh no, there is quite a lot I think you do not know. For instance, I do not think you know very much about Bravo, yes?
I dare say we don't, but we need to make a go of it.
Bravo, bravo.
And I don't suppose I'm such a terrible cook.
You are without a doubt a charming cook. But Mrs. Austin, let me give you as a piece of advice. Do not be too trusting. You have references with these guests of yours, no?
Is that usual? I thought people just came.
It is advisable to know a little something about the people who are sleeping under your roof. Take myself, for instance. I show up saying that my car has overturned and it's not your fault. But what do you know about me? Nothing at all. I could be a thief, a robber, a madman, even a murderer.
Oh.
And you see, perhaps you know just as little about your other guests.
Well, as far as spoil goes, I should say we should draw your smart bowl after I know letters in here, I guess.
Allow me to poke the fire.
Okay.
Excuse me, Miss Austin, is your husband up? And the downstairs room, the pipes in the closet.
What an awful day.
Please.
Thank you so much.
the microphone.
What have we done?
You have nothing to do with this place.
Maya thought it turned over and snowed.
I see. What I'm getting at is that anybody who's been following you around wants very know well that you will have to work coming with you. Now there's one thing I want to know, and I want to know it quick. Which one of you is it that has some business with the Longridge Farm pigs?
Christopher Wren. I was a mere child at the time.